Hello boys and girls, welcome to this Unreal 5 tutorial. Today I'll be showing you step by step how to use the MassAI with CitySample characters to get pedestrians walking around in your project. So let's get started. First off, we create a new blank project and I'm gonna name my MassAICrowd. First thing we do when we get in is manage plugins and we type in Mass. We enable MassAI and all the Mass plugins. And we don't want to restart just yet. Now we open the Epic Marketplace. And we find the CitySampleCrowd and add it to our project. Once we got added, the first thing we do is open the folder, go to Blueprints, and right-click the BP Crowd character to get it loading, and we should get some requirements in a moment. Now we simply click Enable Missing on all three pop-ups, and then we restart the editor. Now, once we're in, we got everything we need to start playing around. First thing I do is add a zone graph, so the AI got somewhere to go. And you can do it by place actor, type zone graph, and just drag it into the viewport. Let's place a mass spawner too, so type in mass, and drag it the mass spawner. The zone graph works just like a spline, so you can click the points and extend them by holding shift and dragging off. You can do more or less any shape you want. I'm just gonna make a nice square. Now let's come down to the lane profile. We gotta make a new profile. Create profile, and we just click plus on the lane profile, expand it, and you add two lanes, one for forward and one for backwards, and you should probably give it a name. I just forgot. I'll go back in and do it. And now we select the new profile we made. And in the viewport, you can see we got two new blue lanes. For the new zone graph shape to work, we gotta build the built zone graph. So we do that. Now in the zone shape details panel, we go down and we add a tag, and I'm just going to use the default tag, but you can specify if you want different types of streets or lanes. And now I'm just going to save the new map. It's a good idea to enable zone graph display. Do that, and we got it here, we can always see it. Now let's add a new state tree to tell the AI what to do. Now let's open the new state tree. First thing we got to do is change the schema to mass behavior. Now click the root, and we got to add a new evaluator. Click the plus sign and you select zone graph annotation tag. That's all we need in the root. Then we're gonna add a new state. And I'm gonna call this wonder. And we're gonna add a transition. So when we're done, we go back to the root. And then we're gonna add two new tasks. We're gonna add a wonder target and a follow path. Now expand the two new tasks, and under wonder target we gotta add the same tag we did on our zone shape. Under path follow we add a movement style, and then we click bind on the target location and we simply select wonder target location. That's all we need to do in the state tree, so let's compile and close it. Now let's add a new data asset, and we want the class type to be a mass entry config asset. Now create it. I'm gonna name my new data asset MassAgent, and once we're done naming it we can open it, and in here there's a lot of things we gotta add. Now expand the config, and we gotta add a lot of traits. I think we're gonna add 10 or 11, so just add them now. And the order that you add them doesn't really matter, but I'm gonna start with the assorted fragments. This is a special one. If you expand, you can add more fragments underneath. And there we just want to add a mass agent fragment. Then let's add a crowd visualization. And we need to add a crowd member. Next, let's add a zone graph annotation. After that, let's add a zone graph navigation and a state tree. Now let's expand the state tree and select the state tree we made earlier. Now let's add movement. Then we'll add avoidance. And we add steering. Then we add smooth orientation. Next we add agent orientation sync. We need to add one more fragment though. And the last one is agent movement sync. And we're done in here for now, but we gotta get back later. Let's save and close. Now let's make the AI character. So right click on the BP crowd character and duplicate him. And I'm just gonna change the name to Mass Crowd Character. Now double click the new character we made. And in here we can go to class settings. And we're going to change the parent class to a character. It's going to ask us if we want to reparent, and we want to reparent. Now we got a new character mesh that we want to be the parent of all our meshes. So let's delete all of them and drag them onto the other one so it's parented. And let's see. Now let's start fixing some of these errors we got here by clicking on one. And what we got here, we got the old mesh, so we gotta replace it with our new mesh. You drag in the mesh here and you just reconnect it and delete, and you just go through all of them and basically do the same. Now that we're done with that, let's save and recompile. And we should be able to see our new character in the viewport. Let's just do some adjustments. Let's pull him down, like minus 85 is normally a good value. So we pull him down, and then we're gonna rotate him by minus 90. Now let's compile and save. Now let's create a new animation blueprint. And let's select the SK base skeleton. Now let's open our newly created animation blueprint, and we want to drag in a walk forward. So let's just do that. Hook it up to the output pose and compile and save and exit. Now reopen our MassAGent character and go to mesh, and let's select the animation we just made. There you see he's walking. Oh, his hair is not parented, so let's just find the face and parent all the hair to the face, and we should be good. Now we just need to add a new component, and that's a mass agent. We can add the mass agent, and then we gotta assign the entity configuration we made earlier, like that. I think that's all we gotta do in the characters. Let's compile and save it. Now let's open the mass agent data asset again. We gotta assign some configurations in here. What we gotta do is we gotta open the navigation and add the tag as we used earlier. Make sure you use the same tag, doesn't matter what it is, as long as it's the same. Let's come to crowd visualization, and in here we have a few options. I'm just going to make it very simple, so I'm just going to skip the static mesh and go for the high res actor. Here we go with our MassAGent character, and I'm going to add it to the low res actor too. And then you expand parameters, LOD parameters, and we simply tell it to use high res character everywhere. Even in the off state, you want to use the high res character. Now we find and select the mass spawner, and we tell it how many spawns we want. We want 10 for now. Entity types, we want the data asset we made earlier as agent, and we want a spawn data generator. It's the zone graph spawn point generator. And now let's just save our project and see if we can get some AI walking around. It doesn't work, and I think I know why. We forgot to add the crowd visualization. The off state is apparently pretty important. Let's stop the simulation and open our mass agent data asset again, and in here we simply say tell it to use the high res spawned actor in the off state and save it. Now let's simulate again and just wait a bit for it to load. There you go. We got him walking around. Let's remove the AI debug. This is obvious, very simple setup. There's a lot more we can do, but this is just to show how you get started, and you can always tweak around with it. So I hope you found it very useful, and good luck with MassAI in your projects. If you encounter any problems, please add a comment and I'll see if I can help you out. Anyway, good luck and goodbye.